You know, it's time. Unpopular opinions. Unpopular opinions. This is not going to be fun. All right, people, here to go. It is time. Something that just ran across my mind. I'm basically talking off right off the top of my head. And something popped in there about unpopular opinions, because we all got our theories on shit. I got my little, not conspiracy theories, but I got my own theories on how shit might be working, you know, because shit, none of us know for certain what's going on. But I'm going to tell you right now, if you got any sensitivities about anything that I say in this video, just stop watching. Just stop watching. It's simple enough to just click off the video and no watch no more. If I say something and you get automatically triggered because of life events or whatever the hell, it is what it is. You can just click off the video and go watch something that makes you feel good. Because this is not going to be one of them videos, because I'm going to talk about some shit. I got a couple of things in mind that I know is going to trigger some folks, and I'm talking off the top of my head, so some other shit might pop in there. So that is just a fair warning right there. So let's get going. A global reset. And a global reset to me is the world trying to get back to a normal state. You know how you work out? You know how you work out and you put on a lot of muscle. You know, you get buff or whatever. Then you stop working out. Your body goes, you know what I'm saying? Your body goes back to like I am now, basically. Or when you get fat. A lot of people don't know, but when you get fat, you actually lose weight faster than somebody, normal body composition. You know what I'm saying? You do. You know, your body tries to stay at a balance. This planet that we live on operates, in my, you know, little weak-ass opinion I got, in the same thing that it's always trying to keep a balance. The what's keeping us from what's keeping the world itself or the planet from that balance is us humans. You know what I'm saying? We are the virus. You know what I'm saying? We are the virus. We can either be a good bacteria. I don't know if they have good viruses. I know they got good and bad bacteria. I probably should have said bacteria at first, but for the most part, we're a virus. It's just, you know, it's a one-sided affair. It's not that, I can't even think of the word right now where it's mutually beneficial. We're trying to. Most of us, some of us are trying. We're trying to get to that, but I don't know how it is. I don't know if y'all watched that movie, The Happening, but that's something I caught with The Happening. If you watch that M. Night Shyamalan movie, it's like that, to where, you know, if you watch that goddamn movie, basically the plants put out this pheromone and make people start killing themselves. That's basically it. You know what I'm saying? I can just say that right now and just cut this fucking video off, but I'm not. But that's basically what the fuck I'm getting at. A lot of what we're suffering from on Earth itself is overpopulation. And what we don't have is survival of the fittest. You know what I'm saying? We don't have that. Everybody gets to live a long, grand life. Not everybody, but you know what I'm getting at. You know, get to live this long, grand life, which actually causes more problems you know, than we tend to realize, or it causes more problems that we are able to counteract. You know, overpopulation, overconsumption, over everything, because quite frankly, there are too many goddamn people. You know what I'm saying? It's too many people. And if it's not too many people, it's too many people in one fucking space. It's a big planet. You know what I'm saying? If we were evenly spread out, you know what I'm saying? And you can tell this, if you've driven anywhere across state lines, how much land is unused, unpopulated. It's just open. And that's just what you can see from the highway. You know what I'm saying? You just drive from like Houston to San Antonio or Houston to Austin and just look out the window while you driving. You just driving for hours and you just look. Nothing. It's just land. You know what I'm saying? Then you get somewhere like where I'm at. I'm in Houston where it's just, everything just, right here. You got millions of people just packed into one goddamn spot. And that's where our problems come from, you know, with pollution and all kind of stuff like that. Smog where you can't even see the fucking stars and shit at night. Or if I'm looking from my, well, not from my house, but if I'm on a highway or something, like right when I get on the freeway, I'm supposed to be able to see downtown. Well, I'm blind as shit right now, but anybody else supposed to be able to see downtown clear as day where you can just take a picture. Man, it looked like something's on fire. Just smog and all kind of stuff. I think that the world itself is slowly, and this is going to be, you know, well beyond any of our lifetimes, you know what I'm saying? But we're starting to try to counteract that. I think the world itself is going into an involuntary reaction to everything, to where it's like a self-correction. Everything I'm going to say is going to sound real stupid right now, but it is what it is. The suicide rate, homosexuality. Man, I ain't saying anything is wrong with any of that. If you enjoy killing yourself, that's your business. If you enjoy, you know, same-sex partners, that's your business. You know, don't get it like I'm against any of this shit. I'm just going by what I see. A lot of the, the illnesses, and like I said, all this shit, I fall into a lot of this shit. So it ain't like I'm just picking on shit. You know, a lot of illnesses and stuff that's easily avoidable these days. Even though it's curable, a lot of shit is in just, I don't know, man. It kills off, we get sick from a lot of shit that, and the first thing to go is our reproductive capabilities, men and women. You know, we get sick off some shit, boom, you can't have babies no more. You know what I'm saying? The way the social thing is going, everybody is gay now for whatever reason. You know, I know gay ain't new. I know this, so I don't want nobody talking about, I know this, but it's more acceptable these days. And there's a lot more of just, boom, you realize how many people are actually gay. You know what I'm saying? Or prefer just, and I ain't talking about bisexual people. I'm just talking about gay people in general where they don't fuck with it. I ain't talking about people that just fuck anybody. I'm talking about the actual gay folks and none of that new sexuality that people done invented these days. I'm talking about straight, gay, or gender confused or gender whatever. Don't get offended at me. I'm straight. I know what gender I am. I ain't mixed up about it. If you just happen to be, that's your business. I don't care. But a lot of this stuff goes into the play where it start to inhibit, stunt our reproductive capabilities. You know, we're not going to be making as many new people. You know what I'm saying? That's part of the corrective. You know what I'm saying? That's part of the whole corrective thing where, okay, boom. The earth, like, okay, we got too many motherfuckers here. We gonna just, all right, this is what we gonna do. We gonna program some shit in here, and then boom, everything is gonna start to shrink back down gradually. We gotta control this goddamn population outburst. And then you get shit with these, like with the coronavirus and all kind of stuff like that. And with the other outbreaks and shit already. The earth is like, okay, we gonna, earth is on this little laptop. You know how them hackers be in the coffee shop? The earth is in a Starbucks right now just typing up viruses to install in us and boom, boom, boom. Okay, boom. We gonna do all this shit. We're gonna plug this one right here in there. And they put it somewhere. And so human will go fuck with it. And boom, there we go. We got an outbreak. We just gonna kill off a whole bunch of motherfuckers off at once, kind of dilute the population a little bit, ease the stress on the world. You know, that type of shit. You go, boom, boom. We gonna type in some more shit. You know, the earth is still in there, typing up shit. I got a keyboard right here, I'm typing. And okay, boom, we finna type up some shit. We gotta get in these motherfuckers' heads. Cause it ain't a motherfuckers, it ain't enough people missing right now. So we got it now, boom. We gonna create a fucking, I don't know what the fuck you call it. We gonna implant some shit to make like 10% of these motherfuckers just weak-minded as fuck. So every time something happened, they just run off and kill them goddamn selves. Boom. And that's the thing now. I just got through watching something not too long ago that caused a whole lot of people to just lose their goddamn minds, kill themselves over stupid shit. It's, you know, suicide is suicide. You know, it's whatever. People kill themselves. It's not new. It ain't something that just pop up, so don't get a fucking offended. Suicide been around for a long ass goddamn time. So, yeah, if you get offended by it, I don't care. It is what it is. You know, so we gonna do it. Motherfuckers say, your hair's brown when it should have been red. And you be like, my hair is brown and it should have been red. Like, okay, you know, we got all these people out of here now. It's all type of shit. Like that. Okay. Like when the coronavirus first started, first hit. And I ain't talking about the coronavirus killing people. I'm talking about people in general. The crime rate jumped through the goddamn roof right around the time the damn coronavirus hit. Now all these people are stuck in the house. Now it's domestic violence. Families are killing each other and they goddamn kids. Well, we gonna plug this shit into earth. It's like, we gonna get rid of some more of these motherfuckers. So, you know, we gonna make them sit in the house and they gonna kill each other. That's gonna reduce some more stress off the goddamn earth. You know, we gotta make some more room. And for whatever reason, right around that time, the crime rate then jumped up to where, you know, people just out here just shooting people at random. And I'm not even making that up. You know what I'm saying? I'm not even making that up. At least I know, and if it was happening down here in Houston, it was happening a whole lot of other goddamn places too. To where, you know, motherfuckers just driving up the gas station, shooting motherfuckers for no goddamn reason. Not even somebody you got beef with. You know what I'm saying? Let me check. Let me see. Okay, that's the stop. You know, bam. Random ass violence. Motherfuckers, you be sitting outside somewhere waiting on somebody in the car, and somebody just walk up outside of your car, bam, bam, bam. Blow you up, drive the fuck off, walk the fuck off. It was happening every day down here earlier in, throughout 2020. I don't know if it died off any. I think it got to the point where I ended up getting a new phone and I didn't put a Newsbreak on my new phone. So I wasn't getting all the news. I was done. I ain't want to hear about it no more. So boom, you got that. The earth then typed this another little virus into the shit. Stuck another Trojan horse in there. Type that shit in. And then motherfuckers couldn't stay on the street. You know, you had the lockdown. And then everybody started driving around 1,000 miles an hour. Because there wasn't no cars on the road. So people just was driving around fast as they fucking could. Not having driven over 80 miles per hour before. on a regular ass street too, and they just running off the road. They running into pillars. They drive. They literally driving off the freeway, and they driving, running into people that had wrecks on the freeway, causing people to jump off the side of the freeway. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, jumping off 20, 30, I don't think it's 30 feet, but just shit is happening. This is shit is happening. So, okay, this is more, we just knocking people off, man. We knocking people off. And now we got this thing like with Trump is out of office, and then you got Biden in there now, and he on this whole green renewable energy thing. So we got a couple of years of that going. That go right is in there. That's the good virus. That's some good virus we putting in there. We typing that in there to counteract some of the other shit. So we done killed off a bunch of goddamn people. Now we're finna get in here with some good shit. All right, we're going to type this in here, and boom. And I start looking at shit. I'm like, okay, this. It seems like this is what's going on. It might not be as silly as I just said it. You know what I'm saying? But when you put the numbers together, it's almost what needs to fucking happen. We need less people. You know what I'm saying? You get people like me, like right now, at my point in my life, I would be one of the people that get bumped off. I'm not having no kids. I'm 45 years old. I serve no goddamn purpose. You know what I'm saying? Like, literally, I can look at myself objectively and say that. I serve no purpose other than my own needs. I'm not providing for nobody. None of that shit. I'm just taking up resources at this point. I don't need to be here. You know, just unless I got some divine plan in the next few years before I die to have some big impact on something. You know what I'm saying? I don't know that. Maybe. I don't know. Who knows? We don't know. That's why you play the game, baby. That's why you play the game. But that's what I see. I see the world trying to correct itself. Some of us are not a part of the problem, and then some of us are part of the solution. Some of us are just indifferent. For the most part, I'm indifferent. You know what I'm saying? I got shit I got to deal with in the midst of all this shit, the way I can't worry about global health. I try. You know what I'm saying? I put my money into things that's supposed to help, you know, in the long term, that's going to help me in the short term. You know what I'm saying? You know? But that's what I see, man. Like I said, I look at that movie, I said, man, all this shit happened, all these people dying and blah, 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 blah. I'm like, it's a release valve, man. It's a release valve. It's going to happen. It's just like a stock market crash. Or you get when you get not a stock market crash, every so often you get a correction. You know, you get a correction in the stock market to when everything is just shooting up and up and up and up. Every once in a while, shit will just go bloop. It's a correction. All right, shit been going a little bit too good. You know, y'all motherfuckers get a little bit out of hand. Let me knock y'all shit down a little bit. And then it start working way back up. It's called a correction. You know, I that's what I see, man. That's what I see. Like I said, with the suicides, there's people out here killing themselves over shit that don't make no fucking sense at all. And I don't really have sympathy for shit like that because, like I said, my mindset is like, it's already too many goddamn people. You know? It's already too many goddamn people. And then you got people killing themselves over trivial shit. And I know it's different shit mean different shit to different people. But certain shit is trivial. There's people killing themselves over cyberbullying. People are committing suicide over cyberbullying. I got my ass beat as a kid. We didn't have laptops and shit when I was a goddamn kid. We ain't have phones. You can sit in the motherfuckers all day and just look at you voluntarily looking at the shit that you that's upsetting you. You logging in, you looking at this shit, you voluntarily reading this shit that's pissing you off, and it's pissing you off, and it's got you depressed, and you go, ugh. What would you have done when you, if you was my age? Well, you probably wouldn't be my age. You know, if you grew up in the time where I grew up, where you got your ass whooped. You got your ass whooped by teachers at school because corporal punishment was a thing back then. You know what I'm saying? After school, you know, you get one of these, you know, at fucking, well, I don't even know what time kids get out of school, but, you know, at 2 o'clock, you get one of them shits. You trying to figure out how to get off the school property when school let out before you, whoever did this shit to you, get ready to beat your ass over whatever the fuck. You know, I got my ass whooped. I got chased home. I got chased across neighborhoods. All kind of shit like that. You know? And I got home. Once I made it home, boom, I made it home. Boop, I turned on my goddamn Super Nintendo. You bleep, 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 play some Mario Brothers and some Tecmo Bowl. And, you know, I go to school the next day, do the shit all over fucking again. These motherfuckers do some shit. Somebody, they log into their phone, look on Instagram, Facebook, or whatever the fuck, and get the fuck out of here. You know what I'm saying? I have no sympathy at all. And there's some shit that can go on to where you just get beat down over your head over some time with some shit, and you just like, fuck it. Now that, I can fucking understand. Where you just ain't getting no breaks in life, or you get stuck up under some shit, like some real shit, but this cyberbullying shit, get the fuck out of here. This bullying shit that they got going on at school, the motherfucker, you know, call you pimple face or some shit, and you lose your goddamn mind. No. No. I just seen some shit a minute ago. I don't even think it was in the U.S. It's probably another country where this 11-year-old girl killed herself over some cyberbullying shit. Lem years old. I wasn't concerned about nothing. As far as I know, I don't even know what the fuck I was doing when I was 11 years old, but I know damn well I wasn't involved in anything in the magnitude of me killing my goddamn self. That was probably in the years just prior to me getting bullied to death, like for real. You know, for real. For real. Getting your ass whooped by other people. Not nobody calling you names. They calling you names while they beating your fucking ass. And I ain't talking about by one motherfucker either. I'm talking about a group of motherfuckers. Because that's how they did back then. You get jumped. You learn to run real goddamn fast. I didn't go home and cry to my dad about shit. No, one time, you know, I went home and, yeah, and my dad went hunting for the motherfucker too. Him and some other. So, yeah, I mean, it's survival of the fittest, man. Mentally, man, it's upsetting to me that I even have to say this shit. Get your shit together. You know what I'm saying? Your suicide shit, y'all can stop that. You just, if your mind is that weak, you really don't have a fucking place. How the hell are you gonna survive out here? And you can't handle nobody calling your fucking name. But that's enough on that shit. Because it's a whole, I mean, it's more to that shit. And like I said, it's some real deep shit when it comes to suicide. Then you got this whack-ass bullying shit when it comes to suicide. Or the shit with the people that get on reality TV. Then they get off of reality TV. And then, you know, they social media get blowed the fuck up, which is the same as fucking cyberbullying. Or you get the rich people, they can kill themselves because they mentally ill. But I'm like, if you mentally ill, then I mean like survival of the fittest. If you done made millions of dollars and you into your motherfucking 30s and your life is still to the point to where you just ain't feeling it, then hey man, do what you do. Do what you do. Then you got this other shit, this gay shit that we got going on. Like I said, shit ain't gay. If you gay, that's your mind, your business. But I'm like, that's, to me, in my mind, if I had to put it in a place, I'll put it in the place of just stunting the growth of the human race, which, like I said, it's not a bad thing because we are seriously overpopulated. All our problems are caused from overconsumption and overpopulation. You know, it's too many goddamn people. There don't need to be that many of us on this planet, and we ain't populating nothing else right now. So shit, too many goddamn people. And it's getting real hard. I mean, if you like a straight dude like I am, even though I'm past the age of family building and shit like that, even in real dating, I'd be just like, if you look at the dating part of it, it's just like, not the last message I got on a dating site, but I think the message before that was from a goddamn guy. It was a transsexual, but it was a dude none the fucking less. And it's like that, you know, on my date night. It's, if it's a site that I'm fucking active on, I say a good third of the messages I get are from transsexuals, or every so often just like a cross dresser or just a gay dude. And that's depressing enough by itself. It's just, motherfuckers ain't out here populating the earth. They just out here doing what the fuck they do. It's just, but yeah, I mean, but it's abundant, man. It's abundant. And you start to find out that, okay, this person here is gay. This person is gay. This person is gay. It's just like, you know, I'm like, man, hey, the world is trying to reset. It's trying to reset. It's some involuntary ass shit. You part of the thing, whether you want to be or not. You might be afflicted with something, you might not, but whatever you're going through is part of this whole goddamn global reset where the world is trying to get itself back to normal. You know, the only people that ain't, not even people, the motherfuckers that ain't bothered is fucking animals, man. You know, animals. I mean, they're affected by the shit we do, but they not contributing to the problem. It's people that are contributing to the problem. You know, like I said, these motherfuckers, you know, you got this gay shit going on, suicide, and then you got, I don't know how many motherfuckers out here that'd rather have puppies than fucking kids. So that, you know, that's not part of the problem, but it's part of the whole reset mentality that I just invented an hour ago. You know, where, you know, motherfuckers 20, 30 years old, going to their 40s, ain't had no kids. And I say women because, I don't see dudes in that category. If I see a dude that's my age and all he got is a little puppy or dog, he probably gay. I'm not even trying to be funny. It's just, that's the observation. It's usually a gay dude. You know, you got this white lady that just moved down the street. It's just, nice looking one. She got dogs. She ain't got no kids. I don't know if she got dudes coming over the house or not, but it's just, you know, it's a whole thing, man. It's a whole thing. And the whole point of the whole part of bringing this whole shit up is that in order for us to get, well, I ain't gonna say us, in order for the planet, the world itself, to get to a point of I don't know, some kind of level to where it's happy. You know what I'm saying? Like after you eat, you're like, oh, well, the world ain't right there right now. In order to get to that point, either we got to be really on point on how we do things nowadays, as far as the environment and shit like that, or a lot of us can't be here. It's gonna happen either way. It's gonna happen. People are born all the time. People are die. People die all the time. But that's going to, like I say, it's not gonna be as many people born. But then you got people out here that's gonna make up for that because they have like 7, 8, 9, 10 goddamn kids. But whatever. But it's going to get to the point where, okay, we're going to have more people dying off than people that are born, which is going to have to happen. You know what I'm saying? It's going to have to happen. It's just the way the fuck it is. It's just like if you got gangrene in your fucking toes or some shit like that. Well, hey, that shit got to go. It's going to spread. The same thing with the earth. Part of this shit got to go, or else people are going to keep spreading. It's not going to be a good thing. It's just not. You know, it's too many of us. And unless we get to the point to where we, and which is, we working towards it now, but, you know, I think we'll get there. I would have been dead a long time by the time we get to the point to where we ain't worried about the shit we got to do today. Shit that we got to worry about today in the future. It's just like now, I'm like, I live in Houston, you know, so I'm in the southern part of the United States, and I'm like, we damn near don't have a winter down here. That ain't always been the goddamn case. You know what I'm saying? That ain't always been the case. I'm sitting here thinking, and I'm like, okay, I remember when I used to actually have to wear my goddamn jacket somewhere, you know, other than having a cold front that come by and last about an hour, you know. I was looking at my memories and shit on like Instagram and Facebook and shit like that a couple of years ago. Motherfucker, January, it's ice on the goddamn ground in Houston. It's supposed to be. It's supposed to be. You know what I'm saying? You're supposed to have some ice on the ground, maybe a little snowflake every now and then or some shit. Man, at least I know this year, it ain't nothing. I'm sitting there, it was like, I'm looking at the day of. It's like 60, 70 degrees outside. I look at my memories, and it was one of them days where it had snowed. And it was ice on the ground. I remember I had to drive to work. Well, I don't remember. I saw it on the damn, on the feed, on the memory feed. You know, I had drove to work and they had sand and salt and shit on the ground down here. You don't ever see that shit. That was a couple years ago. You don't never see shit down here where they got to put, well, it depends on where you live, if it's a bridge or something where you live in. But I mean, like, this is where I'm like, all the 45 going north was just dirt. You know what I'm saying? It felt like I was driving in the back country on the goddamn freeway. They had covered that whole goddamn freeway because everything had fucking froze. Now, same day, same part of the year, you walk outside with tank top on, no problem. Chill out, sit out on the porch, drink you a tea, margarita, some shit. I'm like, I got to the point, I was like, I want a goddamn winter. I mean, the summers are still fucking hot. You know what I'm saying? We steady climbing that motherfucker. You know, I'm like, goddamn. And if it ain't the heat, well, it's always the heat. But it's like, okay, the temperatures says this, but it feels like this. That feels like keep going the fuck up. Well, it's only 90 something degrees, and that's hot as fuck for everybody else. But down here is, you know, once you get like 90, you like, all right, 92, 93. And once you get over like 93, nigga, you like, oh. You know, you in the house, and if you live in an old house like me, you hot anyway, but it's like, man, this is ridiculous, man. What the hell is going on here? Speaking of that, I got to buy another AC for this room here. Now that I thought about it, I need to do that, like, soon. I need to do it while it's still fucking wintertime, because if you try to go out and buy that shit, like, once it actually start to get hot, you know, all the little window units, because that's what I got to have in this house. They just go out. you won't be able to find nothing. They buy them things up. But yeah, I'm like, the summers are getting hot, and they're getting hotter. And it feels even hotter with my bad-ass health, because like I said, I'm in bad health. I'm in this shit that I'm talking about with people. You know what I'm saying? And the winters are just like mild, man. This is mild. We get some rain. You know what I'm saying? It rained quite a bit the last few weeks. You know, it got cold a couple times. Maybe two or three times we didn't got it where it dropped down to like maybe in the 30s. But not long. It dropped down into the 30s overnight. You know what I'm saying? So when it's like really cold, like when people like some people like to get out and enjoy the cold weather and blah, blah, blah. But it's only cold. Why the fuck you sleeping? Why you in the house? You know, they know people up north, you know what I'm saying? You start to see that shit in the fringes. You know, you see it on the fringes where you used to get a little bit of winter, blah, blah, blah. Now we got some snow down here in this region, but it didn't come far down as Houston. It came down to where it's like, I'd say maybe 40 miles or so north of Houston. That was probably the line. You know, it came down, but it didn't go down past, you know, maybe 30 miles or so north of the city before it everybody else got snow. By the time the shit got down to us, it just fucking rained. You know. No winners, man. And Biden is doing this thing now where he trying to put some money into fighting climate change. He ain't the only one. There's other people out there doing it, but he the president. So, you know, he made it known that, you know, one of his top things is fighting climate change, because there's some shit that I'm fucking noticing. We ain't no winter. It got cold for a couple of days over a 3-month period. That's not a goddamn winter. You know what I'm saying? That's not a winter. And the globe itself is trying to fix this shit. The climate change is caused by all this other bullshit that us people got going on, because there's too many of us on this fucking planet. So the world is trying to turn us off to a certain extent. You know what I'm saying? Whether it makes sense or not, whether you think the earth is putting mind weakness and gayness and all this stuff inside of us to counteract, the fact of the matter is, if you put all this shit together, it adds the fuck up. In my mind. You know, in my mind, yeah, you might not agree. I probably seriously doubt you would, but yeah. I'm like, if the world is trying to reset itself. That's my unpopular opinion. That's my unpopular opinion. I have more of these, and I'll record them, and I might post them. I might not. It just depends, but. Yeah, that's my opinion. The globe is in a reset status right now, in a position, or the fuck they call it. It's early in the morning right now. I don't know. It's in a position of aggression, proceeding towards. It's one word for all that shit I just said, but. It's in a position to put for trying to correct itself without our help. And if it starts to correct itself without our help, that means it's going to be a whole lot of sad people out here and a whole lot of us that won't be around. And, you know, I'm lie to be one of them. Like I said, I'm not putting myself. Like I said, if the shit goes sour, if all the people that need to go had to go, I would be right along with them. I would be on that list. So I ain't up here like, yeah, I'm going to be over here repopulate the world with my seed. No, 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 that's not happening. So I will cut this one off right here. I've been silly enough this morning. And I will catch y'all later. I'm going to go find something to eat, man.